Stand by for words from the commanding officer.
Hello, CFAY. I'm Captain Dave Owen. It's Wednesday, the 26th of June. I got a couple updates to bring to you and events to talk about. First of all, tomorrow on the 27th of June on the fourth floor at the CRC starting at 1330 is going to be the SAPR OC committee meeting. That is the Sexual Assault Prevention and Response Oversight Committee. That is for commanding officers. We've put some messages out already. That's to give you an update on, to talk to the COs and the leadership and get some ideas that have been put out there on how we're going to stop sexual assault. And also looking for feedback from anybody from things, that cool things that they're doing at their commands, so we can get that out to the rest of the community, so we can eradicate this thing that's been giving us too much trouble for way too long. On Friday, the Honcho Patrol, because the one last week got rained out, is going to be done this Friday on the 28th of June. Anybody interested in participating can meet down at the main gate, that's Kearney Gate, at 2215. This is a community relations project where you can go out in town with some of the local officials, walk around, pick up some trash, and help make Yokosuka look better. All those that use the Fleet Rec Food Court, Mean Jeans and the Hot Stuff Pizza will be closed next week on July 1st through the 3rd. This is due to an exhaust fan replacement project that's going on, so the Mean Jeans and the Hot Stuff Pizza at the MWR Food Court at Fleet Rec will not be open on those dates. I got several things coming up for the 4th of July, starting on 2 July at 1800 in Opama. The Bay Stars have a game. They're going to try to make it kind of like a independence or American theme that night. They're going to have some booths set up, and potentially we can get some people to participate maybe on some pregame events. I'm supposed to try to throw out a first pitch again. That's always an adventure. And they may play some American traditional baseball songs like Take Me Out to the Ball Game during that game. So come on out. It's only 1,000 yen for adults, 500 for students. So over in Apama, it's a short train ride from Shiori Station. So come on out to the ball game that evening and check it out. On the 4th of July itself, we've got a four-mile run called the Firecracker 4-Mile Run. It's called With Color this year because what you need to do, and if you're in this event, is you wear a white t-shirt, because at about every mile marker or every mile or so, they're going to spray colored water on you. So you're going to be finishing it and you're going to be all colorful and beautiful. I don't know if they're going to just do red, white, and blue, but they might do other colors also. This one does have an entry fee though of $15, so you do have to pay an entry fee for this event. For the softball players on 4th of July, there's going to be a one-pitch softball tournament, so get your teams together for that. And we also have a horseshoe tournament that'll be held down at Berkey Field on the 4th of July at 10 o'clock in the morning. So all those who like to pitch the horseshoes, you can come down and participate in a tournament there. Then on the 5th of July is our actual base 4th of July celebration. There'll be some fireworks in the evening. We've got about a 10-minute show set up. Also, there will be Gary Sinise and the Lieutenant Dan Band is going to be here on the 5th of July, and they'll have some things set up over in the parks like petting zoos and things of this nature, so there will be stuff going on the 5th of July as well. On the 8th of July, there's two intramural sports that are going to start up, so if you're into basketball or softball, then the intramural softball and basketball leagues are going to start up the week of July 8th. As far as Captain's Cup goes, we've got the CORAC Captain's Cup Ultimate Frisbee Tournament coming up. That is going to be on July 13th. So, commands, get your teams together out there. Remember, we're still going after and trying to dethrone Subgroup 7. On the 3rd of August, the Friendship Festival is going to happen. We're planning on having the Friendship Festival on the 3rd of August. So that should be a really good event. We always get a lot of people come to that, and the city is shooting off a large firework display that evening as well. So come on out to the Friendship Festival. It'll be a good time on the 3rd of August. On the 12th through the 16th of August, there'll be Vacation Bible School. Its theme this year is called Kingdom Rock. They are looking for volunteers to help with the program, so you can check with the Chapel of Hope, either go over there, call them, or check their Facebook page if you're interested in volunteering. I have a couple PWD project updates to talk to you about. As you've seen around the base, they continue with the bus stop replacements. 9 of the concrete bus stops are going to be replaced. You've seen some of them torn down, and the new plexiglass ones going up with the aluminum frames. They did start getting the benches in, so I know for a while they had the new ones up with no benches, but over the weekend they started getting some of the benches and they started putting those in place. They're still working on the paving and striping for the parking spaces around Berkey Field, but that's almost done. That should be done on the 2nd of July, and then the whole Berkey Field project will be completed with the repaving and all that. And you've probably noticed over at the NEX that they're renovating the and expanding the beauty and optical shop. That project started last week. It's going to be working on that all the way up to about the end of November. So that project is in progress. Some other things coming up to do. It's almost Mount Fuji climbing season. I mean, July and August is Mount Fuji climbing season. MWR is already holding their safety briefings. Those are held on Tuesday evenings over at fourth floor of CRC, the Community Readiness Center, from 1730 to 1830. To go on an MWR Mount Fuji tour, to climb Mount Fuji, you have to go to the safety briefing first. But it's good for 2 years, so you can go up it this year and you'll still have your card ready for next year. Of course, the Japanese saying is, a wise man climbs Fuji once, a foolish man climbs Fuji twice. But I've been up it 4 times, so I don't know what that makes me. If you're interested in getting some lifeguard training from 25 June to 2 July, American Red Cross is doing lifeguard training. If you're interested, you can call 243-2052 if you want to get trained as a lifeguard. As far as schools go, of course, they're out for the summer now, but you must re-register your students before the next school year comes. If you didn't do it during the re-registration periods, you can still go over to the school offices and get that done. If you don't, there'll be a good chance that your student will not have an assigned teacher at the start of the school year. So get over there and still please make sure that your students are re-registered for school this coming fall. We continue with our summer AC turn-on period. In fact, it's just about all on now. Reminders, though, the guidances this year is to set your thermostats no lower than 80 degrees Fahrenheit or 27 degrees Celsius as we try to conserve the energy and meet the goals that have been mandated down to us. On to the trivia now. From my last show, the song I last was and I was looking for was Arlington by Trace Atkins. Francis Simpson gave the answer for that one. This question did not get answered, so it's still out there. How is a military working dog's rank determined? How is an MWD's rank determined? I mean, they have a rank, but how do they earn rank? And the movie I was looking for was Bull Durham, where Crash Davis set the minor league record for home runs. And that also was answered by Francis Simpson. So thank you, Francis. I have 3 new trivia questions. A song. Here's the lyrics. Give me the title and an artist. Justice will be served and the battle will rage. This big dog will fight when you rattle his cage. I think that was pretty easy, actually. Here's a movie. Based off the autobiography of a veteran named Ron Kovic. What is the movie that was based off an autobiography of a veteran named Ron Kovic? And who was the actor that played him in that movie? Finally, a sports question. Seeing the 4th of July is coming up. How many 4th of July home runs were hit by Mickey Mantle? And how many 4th of July home runs were hit by Willie Mays? The only hint I will give you is the all-time home run record hitter Barry Bonds hit only 3 on the 4th of July, and both of these guys hit more than he did on the 4th of July. All right, CFAY, that's all I got for now. I hope you have a safe weekend and a safe week. Remember, good shipmates don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs. And good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted. Have a great day, CFAY.